I'd like to welcome everyone here and thank you for joining us on our virtual Zoom meeting for an open house. This is our first one. So I'd like to start by introducing myself. My name is Jim Porter. I've been in the industry since 1978, and I work with Mick Vollmer, and the kids call him Mr. V, and he's also been in the industry for well over 40 years. So we're going to share a few things with you today. First of all, I want to talk about what we do. So when we talk about Warren Tech and the Auto Collision Custom Program, we do everything that a normal body shop would do, all the way down from checking a car in, washing it, doing any detail work that may need to be done, writing the estimate, ordering parts, replacing parts, doing any repair. And even back in the paint shop, we will actually do the paint, block sand, clear, everything that has to do with fixing a car. So when I say that, we also too have the same chemicals that we deal with too that a normal body shop would have. So when your son or daughter comes to the program, the first part of the program will be learning about all the chemicals and what happens. And there's a safety test at the end. And not that the student has to pass that test, but the student has to get 100 on it. There's not a single question on that test that we don't feel is important for the student to know. So how do we do this? Well, we do this by students will learn probably something to do on the computer, and then they'll go out in the shop and actually perform that task, whether it's something as simple as taking a taillight out or something more complicated as taking a front clip off or taking a door apart. So one of the things that I think the students really enjoy about this Warren Tech is the fact that they get out from behind the desk. When they come to Warren Tech after their orientation, 80 to 90% of their time that they spend in Warren Tech is actually out working with their hands, making things, fixing things. It's real important. Another thing that we really pride ourselves here is we're a family. This is a Warren Tech family, and I really feel that all the students feel like they belong. So we're going to take a few minutes here and look at what we do.
Here we go, here we go. Red lights out, we never stop. A dreamer with the fever to be famous. All I ever want was that I ever wanted. A fighter with the fever for the famous. All I ever want was that I ever wanted. Got to say like, bang, 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 bang. This fire's a weapon. Bang, bang. Don't stop till we're legend. Here we go, here we go. It's my turn to make history. Here we go, here we go. You know I'm gonna never remember me.
So students demonstrate learning through many different ways. One of the biggest things that we do is when the students arrive here every day, they punch a time clock just like at a job. And on that time card that they have, at the end of the day, they will write down what they accomplished that day and give them a score, hopefully on what they have accomplished. And I will look at that and I'll either agree with their score or I may help them out and change some of it. And on the back of the time card, there's a place on Monday that they'll write down what their goals are for that week. And their last day that they're here, they'll write down whether they achieve those goals or not, and then the reason they did or the reason that they didn't. Because I really feel in this industry, if you don't set goals and standards, it's really hard to make the money that we're all hoping that we could make. So here we can see that we have students here that actually get to spray paint. There's a lot of tech schools around the country that all they have is tap water to spray with. We have a lot of industry people that help come in and help us. PPG Paint helps us with paint. And then they may use our classroom for their training once in a while. So your student may be home for a week if PPG comes in and helps. But they give us and help us out with a lot of our paint materials and allows our students to actually spray primer, actually spray sealer and paint, and actually spray the clear. So because of our relationships that we have with industry, our students definitely have an advantage. And other things that we do is when we cars come in and we're in the body shop, they're fixing dents. They're doing R&I, removing and installing, taking things apart, putting them back together. The other thing that we do, we have welding. We do welding on steel. We have a 110 and 220 welders, as well as we weld on aluminum, and we also have MIG brazing. MIG brazing is kind of the new thing in the industry right now. We do our best to make sure that our students keep up with the modern technology. For instance, Honda on their boron steel, the only welding they allow us to do is MIG brazing. So it just keeps our students up with the latest trends that's going on in the industry. If you're in the custom, we also do, we have some airbrushing. It's amazing the talent and the creativity that some of our students have, something as simple as an airbrush. We also too have the English wheel and bead roller. The students are able to make their own projects. And the biggest thing, one of the first important jobs a tech would have in a body shop would probably be R&I. When I say R&I, we remove and install. There's definitely a trick and it's a good skill set to be able to take a panel off, take a door apart without breaking any clips, without breaking the trim panel, but more importantly, put it back together and actually have that door operate as it did before the accident. We can see here where students welding in a rust panel on an old Jeep that we had taken in. So it's all the aspects of it. After that panel's rust hole is welded in, it's mudded up, it's primed, and actually painted. So it goes through all the steps of doing a repair. When it comes to mechanical work, we also do some mechanical work, especially if it pertains to an accident. If we get a car in here that's hitting the wheel and we have to take that strut and knuckle and axle out of that car to do the repair, then of course that's a mechanical part of it. Same thing if a car gets hit in the front and the radiator or the intake manifold gets damaged, well then we'll be doing some mechanical work when it comes to that. And then even on the custom side, we still do a little performance. I know we have a 350 Chevy in here that we've done a lot to, and we've actually had it apart three or four times, and actually it still does run. And back in paint, also, the last step is we do cut, sand, and polish. We actually bring the vehicle up to show quality. And how we do that is by doing a sand and polish. And we have three different steps that we do on our polish to actually make the car look like a show car. Another important thing that we do here is we do estimating. There's a lot of jobs out there in the industry that would pertain to estimating. I get calls all the time from insurance companies. Do you have somebody that would like to come out and work for an insurance company writing estimates? Estimators in body shops. If you're good at writing an estimate, you can make a pretty good living actually at writing estimates. We also give a lot of certifications. I know SB2 is a big one and it's out in the industry. A lot of times shops will ask our students if they have any SB2 training or certifications. But probably our biggest one is we work very closely with ICAR. In fact, we teach the ICAR curriculum here at Warren Tech. And I do teach ICAR class to industry people at nighttime. And because of that, ICAR gives us this curriculum for free. But more importantly, it allows us, our students, to graduate at least at a pro level one. And some students have even graduated at a pro level two. Now, it may not mean so much, but in a body shop, if a body shop's not gold standard, insurance companies won't send any work to that shop. So the fact that our students are already at that pro level one, it helps out with the shop certifications. Now, if a shop hires a technician with no ICARs at all, it's going to cost that shop anywhere between $1,800 and $2,000 to get that employee to that pro level one status. And our students are already there when they first hire them. So we talked about our credits and stuff. So we have that 1.5 elective. And then we also do give a science credit too as well, which definitely helps out. Your students can graduate now with 44 college credits, which are practically, I mean, it's free credit. And it's the same kind of work, whether a student comes here as a Red Rock student or high school. So why not give that high school student that college credit as well? In fact, we've actually had two students that received their high school diploma at the same time they got their associate's degree. So other thing that the students do is we have a skills club. And the students vote for president, vice president, treasury. And these students run this club. And they'll earn their own money through car washes or car sales. But they also, too, like at Thanksgiving, they'll do food drives. And at Christmas, they'll do toy drives. And they'll do things for the community as well. And then we also have competitions as part of that skills. So we'll start out having a district competition. So we're bringing judges away from this that aren't part of the school and judge the students on how well they either do paint or do body. And the third competition is for estimating. And the top three places at district move on to state. And when you go down to state, and it's usually down in Colorado Springs, but all the tech schools from around the whole state, we all meet down in Colorado Springs and compete against each other. And then if you happen to finish first at state, then you go on to nationals. 2 years ago, we had Todd, who did finish first, and he actually went on and competed in Louisville, Kentucky. And I've been teaching here now for 14 years, and we've only had 2 years that we didn't have a student go on to nationals. So when you get to nationals, it's a whole new ball game there. So you have the best from every state meeting at one place in Louisville, Kentucky, and competing against each other. So the competition is pretty fierce. Todd, that we took 2 years ago, he was a first-year student, and he did. He finished seventh even at nationals. So, you know, congratulations to him. We also have had two students who have actually won nationals and went on to international competition. Our first student went to Helsinki, Finland, and competed there, and he finished 14th in the world. And our second student, apparently they had ran out of money and wasn't able to go to Dubai, but still remarkable that we've had such dedication from our students to achieve these high awards. So we have a few students here that would like to share with you what they enjoy about Warren Tech.
My name is Madison Walker. I'm an auto collision repair student at Warren Tech in Lakewood, Colorado. I got into the collision industry because I enjoy working with metal and vehicles. It's very rewarding to see your finished product in movement and fulfilling a purpose and a need. When I got here my first year, though, I realized I had a much more important purpose. I had to become an example for any girl who wanted to come into this industry. And it became essential to me to prove that not only do girls belong in the shop, but that we can be the best of the best. I personally have already achieved my Pro Level 1 ICAR status, and I'm working towards my Pro Level 2. I earned a scholarship and the Pride Award. In the future, I plan to open my own collision repair shop and continue to be a leader for women and men in the industry. To me, leadership is about inspiration. It's about spreading passion and making a difference. If I can persuade another student to want success in the way that I do in the industry that I love, then I have been successful. When I look back on my career, I want to know that I did make a difference in the collision industry, and I want to know that that is my success.
Todd Pease II. I'm in Warren Tech Automotive Custom and Collision Repair. When I went here, I immediately fell in love with just working on cars and fixing up stuff. So I went to Skills USA competition for state and national competitions. So I went to state, got first place. I went to the national championship and I got seventh place nationally. I got a bunch of free tools, free scholarships, and overall it was a really cool experience. I did pretty well by just paying attention and doing the work and, you know, practicing and keep trying. And what I want to bring to the industry is just passion to fix stuff instead of just getting the job done. Watching the car come in completely destroyed and hammered, and then pulling it out completely brand new and fine, looking really good. It's probably the most satisfying part.
Hello, my name is Brooke Simpson. I am a third year at Red Rocks in Warren Tech. I want to talk about a few things that I like about the collision repair classroom. First of all, I like that you learn both sides. You learn body, welding, painting, pinstriping, airbrushing, R&I. You learn way more than just body bumper repair and just learning how to paint a car. It's a very fun and exciting experience, and I hope that people get to experience it. Bye.